And the Philippine Stock Exchange Index has more or less traded sideways this week. Gio Perez of Papa Securities says there hadn't been any real catalyst to budge the market, not to mention that much of the action was also focused on Merrymart IPO listing last Monday. Gio says the technicals are pointing to a resumption of the PSE index's uptrend. Indicators are pointing to a significant support area near the 6,000 to 6,200 level. The FTSE rebalancing kicks into effect today at market's close, so Japheth says we'll have to see whether that brings out a breakout in the PSEI, just as we witnessed during the recent MSCI rebalancing last May 29th. Well, with us now for more is Aaron Tsai, consultant at First Metro Securities. Good to have you back on, Aaron. Welcome to the program.
Hi, good morning, Kathy. Thanks for having me.
Sure. So U.S. jobless claims fell less than forecast, showing only gradual improvement. Looks like the market has already discounted all the positive news in its recent up move.
Yes, I think the concerns remain to be the uncertainty brought about by the COVID-19. Although we have seen that efforts by the government and various sectors seem to be improving, but I think that has yet to produce significant dent on the trajectory of the COVID numbers. So I think we noted that worries that came after the economy tried to slowly reopen with NCR continues to post daily cases, which has lately been averaging around 400 to 500 cases. And we noted some news from the U.S. that some cities have recorded some spikes in COVID-19 cases. So I think these developments have so far convinced me that despite wanting to be optimistic, especially about the easing and eradication of COVID-19, I think that risks remain. And perhaps that contributes to the cautious sentiment suggested by the recent price action in the market, both in the Philippines and in the U.S.
Right. So how do you see what goes on in the U.S. impacting the emerging markets? Does a rally in Wall Street lift all boats? And if so, is the Philippine market in a position where valuations are comparatively more compelling than its peers?
Yes, I think in the U.S. markets, I am a bit worried about the recent price action because we have seen efforts from all sides, you know, from all angles being supportive of the efforts against the virus, and yet the market is moving sideways. No, and last week the U.S. markets, based on its chart, among the broad indices, the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and NYSE Composite, they all made a bearish candle pattern. We call it a dark cloud call. Somehow, when we saw them before, they preceded a down move. No, and what we saw for the Nasdaq. Yes, it did make a higher high, you know, a breakout at that, a new all-time high, but it did so with a declining momentum, which is, for me, is a not-so-good sign, and we call it a bearish divergence. No? So as far as that is concerned, if it continues to move sideways with a downward bias, then emerging markets, the Philippines included, can be negatively affected, and we have been seeing it in the charts of our own PSEI. However, we look at it in the monthly, the daily, the weekly charts. There are certainly signs that the market might be topping.
Right, and the PSEI has opened lower at 62.93. It's already down about 0.9% at the get-go. The FTSE rebalancing takes effect at the end of the trading day. What's that likely to do to stock prices towards the end of the day's trading?
Yes, first and foremost, the FTSE rebalancing today is relatively smaller compared to the other rebalancing of other indices or major indices. No, but however, we expect some outflow on the big names in the index, namely SM, AC, SM Prime, of course, Ali and BDO, to a certain extent, Telephone. To a certain extent, even if PLDT has the most outflow expected from this FTSE rebalancing, since its weight in the index has been lowered compared to where it was historically. We expect not so big moves, no, for TEL, although big nonetheless, no. And we note that this has already been announced in the past weeks, no. So we expected that funds, especially those active funds that partially tracks FTSE, might have already made their adjustments. However, we noted that passive funds, which closely track FTSE indices are still mandated to do their realignment at the close of business day today. So we expect from them the bigger part of the estimated outflows from the FTSE rebalancing.
Right. Final point, Aaron, your advice of investors, do they take profit now or wait a little more?
I think for me, it's since we're seeing in the charts of the PSEI and hitting some signs from the topping U.S. market, I think it's prudent to take some profits off the table. Hopefully, you did have profits from the strong upsurge from the 4,000 low. However, we note that if we fall from here, that the 616 should provide immediate support. If it doesn't, if it failed to give support, then your next would be around 5950. If 5950 fails again, then your support would be a bit concerning at around 5.4. But if we see the market going past through 6,800, 6,900, then we reverse our view and we think that the market can go at least 7,500. But don't look at 7,500 yet until we break above that 6,869.
Right, I'm not looking that high, at least not yet. Thanks, Aaron. You keep well and have a good weekend. Aaron Tsai, First Metro Securities.